Each PLCnext controller features a WBM, or web-based management. With the web-based management, you can get static and dynamic information about the controller in the browser, and at the same time modify controller settings. You can reach the WBM in two different ways. One way is to click the button in the cockpit of the PLCnext engineer. The web browser opens. The other way is to directly type in the IP address in the browser. For a safe communication, the web server uses a certificate automatically generated by the controller. It might have to be authorized in the browser to be recognized as a secure page. This is not the case. How you authorize a certificate in the browser is further described in the manual of the controller. But you can access the page anyway by clicking on Details and go onto the web page. You now reach the login page. In the login page, you have to type in your username, the password. The default username is admin, and the password is printed onto the controller. You now access the homepage of the web-based management with a picture of the controller as a center. On the left, the name of the controller is displayed, as well as the product key. On the top right, your further information on the project name that's been downloaded onto the controller, the hardware, the firmware, and the MAC address. On the top left, you can switch between German and English. On the left, you can see the five different functional areas: information, diagnostics, configuration, security, and administration. Let's start with information and the general data. Here you can see general data on the controller, like the vendor, the order number, or the serial number. In the diagnostics area, we can get information regarding PROFINET. Here we have three different tabs: overview, device list, and tree view. In the overview tab, we can get information about the functional status of the controller and the IP settings. In the device list and the tree view, we can get details and status information of the connected PROFINET devices. The configuration area provides status information on the connection between the controller and the PROFINET cloud. You can also manage the use of the PROFINET services. The security area is divided in three different sections. The first one is user authentication. In the user authentication section, you can activate or deactivate the use of user accounts, manage existing user accounts, or add new ones. In the certificate authentication section, you can manage certificates for the secure communication of the controller. For that, you have trust stores and identity stores. In the trust stores, trusted certificates and revocation lists of possible communication partners are stored. In the identity stores contains your own certificates. In the firewall section, you can get general status and configuration data on the firewall. It also provides the basic configuration, which are predefined firewall rules for incoming connections. You can also define your own specific rules in the user configuration. In the security area, the administration area follows. This one is also divided into three different sections. The first one is firmware update. In the firmware update section, you can update the firmware of the controller. You first download the desired firmware file on the PLCnext Contact website. You upload by selecting the file here and follow the instructions of the installation wizard. The next section is license management. In the license management section, you can manage licenses of the PLCnext apps. Offline activation is also available by downloading the license files in the PLCnext store. The last section is PLCnext apps. In the PLCnext apps section, you can manage PLCnext apps on the controller. They first need to be licensed in the license management section before installing. By clicking on the controller name on the top, you can get back to the home page.